Hey everyone, in this video we're going to look at the ESP32CAM for the Flipper Zero. I've modified the application to allow us to take pictures which become animations in Momentum firmware. I'll go ahead and exit the application, and now you can see that animation that I just took. And these actually look better on the Flipper Zero screen. I'll show you how to install the hardware and the software, and then we'll take a look at the code. Let's get started. You can typically find these ESP32CAM modules for about $10 US. Sometimes they come with this secondary board that allows you to program them using the USB port. We'll just be wiring the pins directly to the Flipper Zero. On the back of the card, you'll see the ESP32S along with the antenna. And on the front, we have our camera and LED and SD card holder. Pin 9 on the Flipper Zero goes to 3.3 on the camera. For flashing the firmware, pin 18 on the Flipper Zero goes to IO0 on the camera. Next, pin 11 on the Flipper Zero goes to ground on the camera. Pin 13, TX on the Flipper Zero, goes to UART0 receive on the camera. And then finally, pin 14, RX on the Flipper Zero, goes to UART0 transmit on the camera. And again, pin 18 on the Flipper Zero goes to IO0 on the camera, and that's only during programming. It needs to be removed when we're actually using the camera. I've opened a web browser to the Momentum firmware update. We'll click connect and then connect on our device. You can choose either release or dev. I'll choose release and then I'll click on flash. This will take a few minutes to install, but eventually you should see the updated message. Next, we'll open a web browser to my fork of the Flipper Zero camera suite. And then we'll click on the code button and then download zip. Once the file is done downloading, we'll go ahead and open it, and then we'll extract the files. Open the folder it created, and then open the pre-built folder. Bring up QFlipper and go to the File Manager, SD Card, and then Apps, and then GPIO, and then go to the ESP folder, and then right-click on Camera Suite and choose Delete. And then drag our Camera Suite FAP from our pre-built folder into our Flipper Zero. This file will add the setting to create animations using our camera. Next, we'll back up to the root of our SD card. And then we'll go into apps_data and then ESP Flasher. And then we can drag the three bin files into our Flipper Zero. Next, we're ready to install the firmware. Go into Apps, and then down to GPIO, and then ESP, and then go down to the ESP Flasher. And again, your camera should be hooked up to your Flipper Zero, and that IO0 wire should be connected to pin 18. We'll go into Enter Bootloader, and then we'll press the Reset button on our camera. You should see the Waiting for Download message. Go ahead and click the back button on the Flipper, and then go up to the manual flash option. Next, we'll go down to Bootloader and click OK, and then choose ESP32CAM Bootloader. Partition table, choose ESP32CAM Partitions, and then go down to Firmware A and choose ESP32CAM Firmware A. And then we'll go ahead and do a flash fast. But if you have any problems flashing, go ahead and try flash slow instead. That should just take a minute or two. And once you're done, you'll see restoring transmission rate, done flashing. Remove the wire from pin 18 on your Flipper Zero, and then click the reset button on the camera. You'll need to press the back button multiple times to exit out of the app. And then once you have, we're going to go into GPIO and then ESP. And then ESP32CAM Camera Suite. Go ahead and click OK to start. And then for the first test, we'll just do stream the camera. And here you can see the camera is working correctly. I'll go ahead and click the back button, and then we'll go down to camera settings. And my fork has added this new option, frames, which currently says disabled. And this is how many pictures you want in your animation. I'll go ahead and set it to 4 for now. And then we can click back. And now when we go up to stream camera to screen, I'll get my debug duck in focus and I'll click the OK button. Once, twice, 3 times, and 4 times. Okay, so that's our 4 frames. We'll go ahead and click back out to the main menu. And then we'll go over to the momentum settings. And then under interface graphics in asset pack, we have a new asset pack called camera. Go ahead and select that and then back out. And now there's our animation. Again, this looks a lot better on the Flipper Zero screen. And maybe in a future video, we can update the firmware to improve the image even more. Next, we'll look at the code changes I made to create those animations. The blue lines are lines that are just being kind of compressed from our view. The green lines are lines that are added, and the pink lines are lines that are removed. We set the number of frames to 0 so it behaves like the original application. And then in our camera suite structure, we created a new frames variable. And again, this is the number of pictures in our animation. Next, we define the text to display in the settings along with their numerical value. You could add new values here if you're making your own camera suite.fap file. Next, we define the callback function for when the number of frames gets changed in the settings. This just gets the selected index, sets the text using those options from above, sets the frames count, and then it calls create animation files, passing in the number of frames. And then finally, we add a new frames setting. And again, our app's frames was defaulted to 0, so this setting will say disabled. My changes were only made for the default orientation, and I wanted text or logos to not be mirrored, so I used 127 minus X instead of just X. This next section of code is how we make the asset pack for momentum. We define a new folder under SD card, assetpacks/camera. Inside of that is our anims folder. This is where our manifest will live. And then inside of that is an ESP-CAM folder that will have all of our frame animations. We also set all of our frames to use this default image, which is the momentum logo. This is that create animation files that gets called every time we change the number of frames in the settings. If the asset pack folders don't exist, we go ahead and create them. And then we create the manifest.txt file that describes our animation. Our images will be in the ESP-CAM folder, and we'll use the animation regardless of how upset our Flipper is or what level our Flipper is. So after we've created our manifest file, then we're going to create our meta.txt file, and this is saved in that ESP-CAM folder. If the file exists, we erase it, and then we set the number of passive frames, and our frames order is just incrementing sequentially. And then for each frame, we make a frame underscore number.bm, and we just copy the momentum logo into that file. And then if there's any more files left around, like you went from a settings of 6 images to 4 images, we'll go ahead and remove those files. Next, we have the function that saves an image to uncompressed BM, which are the bitmap files used by the animation system. If the ESP-CAM folder doesn't exist for some reason, we'll go ahead and create it. And then we go ahead and open our frame file. The first byte we write is a 0, so this means uncompressed data. And then we loop over each column and then each row. And then we grab the 8 pixels at that array. And for the default orientation, this is the same order the Flipper wants the image in. We invert the data if the is inverted is true. And then we store the bytes in reverse order. That's the order the Flipper Zero needs them in. And then we write each row to our BM file. And then this last change looks a little more complicated than it actually is. We create a camera suite variable from our instance context. And then if the number of frames is 0, we want to do all that original code. So all that code in pink is actually down below. It's just indented, so it's showing up as removed and then added. If our frames is set, we'll set the RGB light to purple, and then we'll save the image as an uncompressed bitmap. And then the final change was to add create animation files method to our header file. Please like and subscribe, and if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me on Discord or leave a comment below.